One of the things we can all agree is wonderful about Christmas is we show untypical compassion to one another, don't we? If we're like a little bit miserable the rest of the year, solipsistically trundling along in a box of isolation. Merry Christmas! Hello! Ah, it's jolly old Christmas. Even these people who fight for a job, doorman, bouncers, muscle, even they get a little bit more jolly around Christmas.
Christmas, we're dealing with thoroughly decent family people that turn into arseholes.
Hey, all right, fair enough, that was a little bit cynical of them, but there's one day of the year, all doormen agree, is worse than any other, and they've got a catchphrase to describe that day, and it's a good catchphrase, and they are rightly proud of that brilliant catchphrase.
Today is Nasty Friday, the last Friday before Christmas, and generally reckoned to be the worst night of the year.
I think it's me that started calling it Nasty Friday. It's always been a particularly nasty night. I can remember going back 30, 40 years ago in London, when it was a nasty night.
Sounds pretty nasty. Nasty Friday, wow. You know, they're hard guys, right? So if they say it's nasty, we've got to assume this is pretty dark, what's going on, right? Nasty Friday! What are the horrors of Nasty Friday? I'm terrified to listen to what went on.
Friday, especially the nasty sort of Friday, really. You've got a bad cocktail, haven't you? We chucked a guy out of a pub once on Nasty Friday, and he was acting in a terrible state. He was spilling beer over people, he was calling women tarts, saying, that's not a skirt, that's a belt. You know, really taking the mickey out of women.
That is nasty! What you're describing is mildly hurtful Friday. No, he was calling women tarts, right? No, he was out of his mind. I don't know if he was on crack or what. One fella, he come up to me to shake my hand, then at the last minute he took it away and went like that. Right? One fella said I got something stuck on the sole of my shoe, and as I looked like that, I went, oh, hello, sailor. There's no excuse for that, even on Nasty Friday. This kind of criminal excess can also lead to excessive festivity, right? Where you just try and cram too much festivity into a song. I don't mind a nice Christmas song, right? And one of the best Christmas songs there's ever been is Wizard, right? With their song, I Wish It Could Be Christmas Every Day. And who among us wouldn't like it to be Christmas every day? But what I resent, right, is Roy Wood getting together with the Wombles to make another Christmas song and wishing for it to be a wombling Merry Christmas every day. That's conceptually difficult. Don't you like the doors, you know? Stop. I wish it could be a wumbling Merry Christmas every day. See, that's going on too long. That's too much. What? Also, I wouldn't mind a wumbling Merry Christmas for about an hour. But not one every day. That's too mental. Oh, this wumbling Merry Christmas is going well. Yeah, let's have it for infinity. There's never ever stop a wumbling Merry Christmas. It's right for the Wombles. They're already Wombles. So the wumbling aspect has been dealt with. For them, all they've got to have is a Merry Christmas every day. But if you're not a Womble, you've got to get into being a Womble and then have a wumbling Merry Christmas every day. That's too much. But perhaps, bless them, perhaps that was a more innocent and in some ways a more beautiful time, right? Because now Christmas has just become about, well, it's commercialization, right? It's about consumerism. But fortunately, some people, some members of the clergy understand that. Some vicars, they're a little bit out of touch. Not this guy, though. He's a vicar that at last understands young people and understands the world of commerce and advertising and those, you know, those Christmas jingles and the promotional tools that you hear around Christmas, you know, those constant adverts that are always on.
I often think about that jingle that you hear in the shops. It's not a carol, the 12 days of Christmas. My true love sent to me a partridge in a pear tree. Well, it always seems pretty absurd, and it's in the shops because it actually is there to encourage us to buy partridges in pear trees.
No, it isn't. That is a carol. You can't buy a partridge partridge in a pear tree? Oh, these bloody partridges in pear trees, they're everywhere. It's a new Buzz Lightyear. That song is not an advert. What about when it gets to 8 maids are milking and 10 lords are leaping? You can't sell them in Argos. 8 maids are milking, only from Tommy. Naturally, consumerism does lead to more crime, but some criminals at least are focused and incredibly professional. Look at this thief, right? He's totally focused on meat and alcohol. It's going to be a really meat and alcohol-based Christmas.
You were charged with, on Saturday, the 15th of December 1979, at Reading in the county of Berkshire, stole one turkey, a joint of lamb, a chicken, a joint of beef, a leg of pork, a pack of chops, 2 bacon joints, a bottle of whiskey, a bottle of curds, a bottle of Bacardi, a bottle of rum, a bottle of brandy, a bottle of sherry, a bottle of vodka, a bottle of coffee.
They just fade out! That's not even the end of it! Their whole Christmas is based around meat. But Father, we've got no Christmas tree. No, well, we've got this pile of meat, beautifully decorated with pieces of meat. There's no Christmas lights. No, no, I've got a string of sausages there. We've got too much of a meat-themed Christmas, right? And also, being poor, like, it don't matter if you're poor at Christmas. It don't matter what the gift is, as long as you put some love into it.
And not very long ago, people used to be extremely happy just to give and receive presents like this, fruit. And I personally would be very happy if someone had gone to the bother or taken the thought to do something like this. 5 or 6 marvellous Cox's orange apples, beautifully polished. That's a marvellous present, I think.
That's fantastic. Just take an apple, just shine that up. That's lovely. You don't need a Nintendo Wii. Just, instead of that, why don't you just give a child a brisk walk? Instead of a trip to Disney World, why not just do a heartfelt smile? It's all well and good to be deeply cynical, but Christmas ain't for the adult world. It's ultimately for children, a celebration of naivety, the innocence of children, to enjoy the magic of childhood in a very special and focused way.
If Jesus came back today, the people that didn't believe in him would threaten him.
I don't reckon anybody in particular would kill him, but people might capture him and say, you turn all my water into wine, otherwise I will shoot you.
And that's the meaning of Christmas. Good night.
Moss is Jen's husband for a tenor in a school reunion nightmare.